Hello everyone, welcome to the course on diffusion in multi-component solids. So this is a live problem solving session for the course of diffusion in multi-component solids, and the course ID is NOC24MM17, and this is for week 11. And we are about to finish this course with the two more weeks, 11 and 12. And we will finish off this wind up this class, and the exams will be conducted online through the NPTEL. Okay, so if you have any doubts or any problems regarding with this courses until week 11, you can ask here or you can ask in a discussion forum, so that you can be easily interact with the easily to get the solution for this one. So this is the week 11, consisting of 5 video lecture series, that is 47 to 51, and in this video series we will be studying about the intrinsic diffusion and experimental determination of the intrinsic diffusion. And next topic in this diffusion in multi-component solid is to study the ternary phase diagram. This is important because to study the ternary system, that is in a multi-phase system, so need to understand how to read the ternary diagram. That will be the most important thing, and it will be useful for other courses also, such as solidifications and other things. And next thing is interdiffusion analysis for the multi-component multi-phase diffusion couples. So till now we have studied the single phase diffusion, but how to study this multi-phase we will be understanding in this lecture series week 11. Let's start with week 47. As usual, this live interaction session will be conducted in two parts. That is, the first R is about to explain the concept that has been covered in the previous week, that is in week 11, and next part is the taking the some of the problems and solving those for the understanding the concepts which are covered in the week 11. Let's start with the first part. So, 47 is having a intrinsic diffusion. So can anyone tell me what is intrinsic diffusion? What is the difference between intrinsic diffusion and interdiffusion? So the flow of an atom in its own concentration gradient, that is in the presence of vacancies and other things, that is called intrinsic diffusion. Whereas in the interdiffusion coefficients, so multiple components will be there, and we will be studying the effect of flux of one component in the presence of the other component concentration gradient. So that's called intrinsic interdiffusion coefficient, and here it is intrinsic diffusion coefficient. So first of all, we have to know the what is the flux for this one. For flux, JA is equals to minus LA dou X. So here you know what is LA. I think most of them are know about these things, these points. That is what is LA and what is mu A by mu A, dou mu X divided by dou X. And this is only valid for when there is no equilibrium in the vacancy approach. That means there is no equilibrium flow. GA is equals to MACA. we will be doing the to determine intrinsic flux J tilde J A tilde is equals to J A plus C A into V K. So here V K is velocity of markup plane. Velocity of markup plane. So in this situation, so diffusion occur by vacancy mechanism. So here the in this situation the diffusion occur by vacancy mechanism. So diffusion will occur by vacancy mechanism. That is example, more the number of atom moves from left to right, and the more the number of vacancies moves from right to left. consider the dispersion of spreading of an ink on a still water as well as the flowing water. The profile looked like in a still water The profile will look like so it is spreading like this. Okay, so in the flowing water, so profile along with the flow of water, it will also move with the decreasing the intensities. Right? So this is the flow. To determine the So in the marker diffusion couple, what he did is, so in the marker diffusion couple, marker so diffusion couple. So what he did is, so one side inside he has taken the brass on which he has wrapped the molybdenum wire, and on which the copper has been placed. This is bronze and this is MO wire, moly wire, and this is copper. Okay, so after the diffusion, so what he will do is, he will cut the after diffusion, he will cut the sample or diffusion couple perpendicular to the diffusion direction. So then he absorbs that. Finally, the marker planes are like here. So initially it was here. So I will make it a different color. So initially it was here, marker planes. So this is the final position of mollifier, and this is the initial position. Okay, so this shows that there is a significant movement of the mollifier. This may be due to the flow of this may be the movement for flow of brass from inside to outside and flow of copper from outside to inside. So intensity diffusion coefficient can be given with the help of, I think this derivation is covered in the video lecture. Ij is equals to, so 1 minus xi d tilde n into ij minus xi summation of d tilde sj. So next, let's talk about the introduction to the ternary phase diagram. So this is brief about the ternary phase diagram. So, in ternary phase diagram, what will happen is So, to study the multiphase diffusion couples, we need to understand the diffusion, we need to understand the ternary isotherm. So, consider this is an imaginary ternary isotherm of for an element A, B, C. This is A, and this is B, and this is C. So I will mention the each and every point. Here the C will increases from 0 to 100. This is the 100 and this is 0. Here A will increases from 0 to 100. I guess similarly, the B will increases from 0 to 100. So, indication of arrow is very important in this case. Okay, so this line will indicate the composition of a binary alloy. For example, if you consider, I will take a different color. So, if you consider this composition, so what will be the composition for point 1? The composition of point 1 is for example this is 10, 20, 20, maybe 25 of C on which it is lying, and one more is here it is, for example this is 10, 20, 30, maybe 90. So this is around 60, you should consider as 60 of B, and the remaining is 80, 85, and this is 15, okay. So it is maybe 75, sorry, I made mistake actually. This is 85 of B. So this is the composition of these lines will indicate the composition of binary alloy. Okay. So what about how you can determine the composition at the middle? So if it is second point, so before getting into the finding the composition of each point, you need to draw a two lines at least. So this is 100%, you just need to draw a parallel lines like this. Okay, so this will indicate the composition of each C component. So this is lying here, so it is plus little bit increased value. This is 11% of C it is having, and 100% is towards this side. Need to draw a parallel line towards this side. Okay, so these are the parallel lines towards the B rich region. So here the point, and here it is about 40, little bit lesser, 38% of B we are having, and remaining is 100% of this one. It is 39, 49, and 51, 15% of A component. So this is the composition of B alloy, ternary alloy. So this is all about the ternary compositions. This should be, you should read the ternary compositions very easily. This with the help of this ternary, you should learn about these things actually. So if you have any doubts, please let me know. Okay, this point will indicate the pure component. One more thing, it may ask in the competitive exams these points. See, so this point, and this point. So this point at the corner of this triangle or ternary diagram, ternary isothermal, will indicate the this is point A is rich in like pure A. And point this point is pure B, and this point indicates pure C. Okay, so this is all about the ternary isotherm diagram, and in detail they have explained in the phase diagram. This one. Video lecture series, and one more thing you need to know. So if you have having little bit greater composition here, so this is alpha, this is beta, this is gamma. So this is same. C is there, and here it is A is there, and here it is B is there. Okay, so this is alpha rich region, and this is beta, this is gamma. In between these, it is beta plus gamma, and here it is alpha plus gamma, and here it is alpha plus beta. Right? This is the composition for the, this is how we need to understand. So I will cue the one ternary phase diagram. Please tell me the composition of this one. So it is having 20, 40. 60, 80. Similarly, it is 20, 50, 60, 80. 20, 40, 60. Instead of that one, I should give outside. Here it is 20, 40, 60, 80. Okay, so this is C. And this is B, and this is right? So if you are considering, I will give some points here itself. Please tell me the compositions. So towards this point, this is considered as 1, and towards this way, composition 2, and at the middle I will give, this is for third point. Yeah, you just tell me the composition for the all the these three. Okay. So please tell me the composition for 1, 2, 3. So I will write here number. So how I calculated this one? First I will draw a parallel to a line A and a line C. It's 100%, right? For C. So if I draw a parallel line to this corner, it is around 10% of C. And what about A? Where is the 100% towards this side? A 100%. So I will draw a parallel line for towards this side, and I will get the composition as 10 same. 10% of A, and whereas here it is 80% of B. This is a composition. Just drawing a parallel lines, we need to determine. Similarly, you can determine for remaining. Okay. Yes. So let's talk about the diffusion path in the ternary systems, in a multi-phase system. So if this is the ternary isothermal diagram that we have, and this is alpha, so I will draw regions also, alpha, beta, gamma. So two regions are there. In between these two regions we have alpha plus beta. Here it is alpha plus beta. If I have considered these two compositions for the division couple experiment, so you know all about the diffusion couple experiments and other things. So if I consider this point and this point for the composition, so I will write it as point A and point B, compositions of couple. So initially it is having this thing, okay? So A point and B point. So it is having alpha region. Since it is lying in the alpha, it is having alpha phase and it is having a beta phase, right? Okay, so after diffusion annealing, how it will go? So it may go like this. So since it is a S-shaped path, okay, so it is moving towards alpha plus beta region. So after diffusion annealing, you will be seeing this kind of path. This is towards A side and this is towards B side, right? So this is alpha and this is beta. This is alpha plus beta. So one more time I will write it clearly. Alpha plus beta. Okay. So you will get a phase region here, alpha plus beta. this is about the formation of multiphase systems if the diffusion path is moving. So please tell me, if my diffusion path is moving, I will change my ink. Okay, so if my diffusion path is moving like this, so it is an imaginary one, it usually it won't go like this. If it is moving like this, please tell me, or else. So one more time I will give it. If my diffusion path is going like this, so what will be the, how this profile will look like? So please tell me that one. So here it is beta is there, you just need to show the beta here, and here it is alpha is there, you need to show the alpha here. So when it is moving from alpha to beta, so first it is showing alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta. So after that, when it is entering here, it is showing gamma plus beta, right? Here the two different phases are present. So alpha and beta, this region and this region. So this is all about the multiphase diffusion couples, and it's how this diffusion path will be varying, and expected micro structures.